Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing zeros of polynomial functions. Our example is to find the zeros of the polynomial function f of x equals x cubed plus 4x squared plus x minus 6. Let's carefully work through it. Solution. So the first step in these problems is to write down what's called the possible rational roots. To find the possible rational roots, what you do is you look at the factors of the constant term, so the term that doesn't have an x, and you divide them by the factors of the leading coefficient. That's the number in front of the term that has the highest exponent. So in this case, it's factors of negative 6 over factors of 1. I'm going to write that. Factors. It's always factors of that last number over, and then you want the factors of the number in front of the x cubed. That's called the leading coefficient. So factors of 1. And this is going to give you all the possible rational roots. This is equal to the factors of 6 are 1, 2, and 3, but you want to put a plus or minus always. It's super important. It'll be plus or minus 1. Plus or minus, actually, 2 is also a factor, and then 3 and 6. So the factors of negative 6 are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 6, over the factors of 1, which are plus or minus 1. So this is equal to, now you can just divide 1 over 1 is 1, so you get plus or minus 1. 2 over 1 is 2, so you get plus or minus 2. 3 over 1 is 3, so you get plus or minus 3. And 6 over 1 is 6, so you get plus or minus 6. These would be the possible rational roots. So step 1 in this problem is always to find the possible rational roots. And again, always the factors of this constant term over the factors of the leading coefficient, which in this case is 1. The next step is to start checking your rational roots. So you can do that by using synthetic division. So it's a good idea to always start by checking 1. I'm going to show you how to check. I'm going to write check 1. So to check 1, what we do is we write down the 1 like this, and we put a little bracket, and we're going to use something called synthetic division. So you write down now all the coefficients of your polynomial. So in this case, it'll be 1, 4, 1, negative 6. So 1, 4, 1, negative 6. And then you draw a line. If you're missing any powers of x, you should put zeros here for those missing powers. So again, we're going to check 1. So you write down your 1, and then you write down your coefficients. 1, 4, 1, negative 6. You take that first number, and you just bring it down. Bring it down, so 1. Then you start the process. 1 times 1 is 1. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 times 1 is 5. 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 times 1 is 6. Oh, this is so good. Negative 6 plus 6 is 0. This is super good because whenever you get 0, that means that this number, in our case 1, is a root. X equals 1 is a root. So we have one of our answers. If you don't get 0, then you just check another one. So it's a trial and error method. So again, you find the possible rational roots, then you just start checking roots until you get 1. Once you get 1 answer, then the next step is a little bit easier. So you wrote down the 1, you wrote down the coefficients, bring down that 1. 1 times 1 is 1, 4 plus 1 is 5, 5 times 1 is 5, 1 plus 5 is 6, 6 times 1 is 6, then you add and you get 0. Whenever you get 0, you get an answer. So make sure to specify your answer. Once you get 0, it's super important because maybe you mess up later or something, so you want to make sure that you let whoever is reading your work know that you actually found an answer. If you get 0, that's one of your answers. All right, the next step is really cool. So because this is a cubic polynomial or degree 3, we're going to start at 1 less down here. So 1 less than 3 is 2. So we write 1 times x squared plus 5 times x plus 6. and we set it equal to 0. So just using these coefficients, 1, 5, and 6, and we know it's an x squared because it's 1 less. If there was a 4 here, we'd have a 3 here. At this point, this equation sometimes is easy to solve, sometimes it's hard. I'm pretty sure we can factor this. Let's try to factor by guessing. So I'll put two parentheses, and I'll put an x here and an x here, and I'll put the equals in the 0. So let's see, x times x is x squared. We need two numbers that multiply to 6, but add to 5. So I believe 2 and 3 will do it. 2 times 3 is 6, 2 plus 3 is 5, yep. A product equal to 0, so you can set each factor equal to 0. So x plus 2 is 0, or x plus 3 is 0. And then here we subtract, and we get negative 2. Here we subtract, we get negative 3. And those are the other answers, and we're done. We have all of the roots of this polynomial. So the roots, I'm going to write them again, are 1, negative 2, negative 3. And this procedure is extremely powerful because you can apply it in theory to any polynomial. It won't always work because you won't always have roots you can find. You might have some really funky ones you won't be able to find, but it'll help you find a lot of them. And this is a technique that is used in much higher level math. So it's really cool that you learn it and then you never know when you're going to use it again. So it's kind of interesting. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video. And if you feel you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.